Welcome to video 3. We'll now come into our supported child's pose again. You can use just the bolster as it is, or utilize a blanket on top of it, or you know, whatever you're using as a bolster. Simply find the height, of course, that works for you. Lengthen on an inhale, and then we'll lengthen and rest down as we exhale and find a nice comfortable position again for our arms and shoulders, where they're coming around the top of the bolster or right alongside with the palms underneath. Making sure your shoulders feel relaxed and just taking several breaths here to allow for a transition after our twist. Neutralizing through the back. Begin to gently press up from your bolster. And we'll transition slowly and gently again into our next pose, which is supported baddha konasana. You can move your bolster up toward the top of the mat, still with it lengthwise. You might have your blankets here at the side to rest your arms. And we'll also be utilizing, if desired, a couple of blocks to support under our knees or thighs. And you can bring your low back and bottom close to the edge of the bolster, a little bit of a tuck perhaps in the pelvis, and then rest all the way down. Your feet can start on the mat if you like. And then you can bring your feet together, the soles of the feet together for the butterfly position for this reclined supported butterfly. Again, using blocks under the thighs or knees to support. And bringing the blankets in to support your arms. If this angle for your back, this curve, feels like too much of a curve, too much of a back bend, then please modify as you need. A good way to modify in this particular setup is to place a folded blanket under your bottom and legs. Particularly under the bottom, to lift your bottom up so it's higher and that doesn't create as much of a back bend. And if the butterfly position with your legs is not fully comfortable, you could cross your legs like a cross-legged position when we're sitting. You could also bring your soles of the feet back to the mat with the knees resting together. Or you could extend your legs long onto the mat. Simply finding the position that works best for you here. Thank you. breath to be a gentle breath, but expand through the belly here as you breathe. Allowing yourself to rest as fully as possible into this back bend. This is a wonderful chest opener as well. If you feel inclined, always feel free to cover yourself with a blanket in this pose. It can help the pose feel more grounded. Or you might want a blanket simply over your feet and legs. To slowly move out of this pose, bring the soles of your feet to the mat, the knees up to the sky. You can bring your hands and elbows alongside you if you'd like to press up gently, engaging your abdominals, or you could gently roll to the side if you feel comfortable rolling off of the bolster. We'll go ahead and set up for our Savasana. I encourage you to have one or two blankets available. One might be for under your head and neck and the other to cover yourself. You can choose to set up like we did in the first pose in the first video with the legs just over the bolster that is horizontal along the lower end of the mat. I'll demonstrate this other option here, which can be with multiple blankets or bolsters. Another option would be to utilize a chair here to place your legs up onto the chair. If you're using bolsters for this option, it's great to bring in a blanket to keep the legs, you know, so they feel contained, you know, and not sliding off of the bolster. And then you could use, of course, a small pillow or a blanket under the head and neck, but you might wish to use your blanket to cover your upper body. Go ahead and find the position that's most comfortable for you, pausing the video if you need for a moment to set up. Allow your body to fully sink into the earth. Feel that your spine is completely relaxed. Your arms can be a few inches out to the sides with the palms up, or you might like them on your belly. Fully and completely releasing your arms and your legs down through your face, throat and neck. Feeling that you're melting into the earth or possibly floating on a cloud. Allow your body and your mind to completely let go. I invite you to stay in Savasana as long as you would like. Or you may begin to slowly come out. As you do come out of Savasana, when you do, be sure to rest on your side for several breaths before raising up to a seated position. But feel free to continue to rest here in Savasana. I hope that you have enjoyed this practice, and I am very grateful for you participating, being here with me. I hope that you carry this rest